JavaScript interviews can be difficult. You get tasks and you don't know which ones. And this one I actually got several years back and I liked it. I got back to it and I played with that and I would like to share it with you. Hi, my name is Robin and I'm a JavaScript developer. I do JavaScript videos about best practices or some language features, or like today I would like to share some tips about interviews. The exercise I'm talking about is called Gilded Rose Kata. And what I like about it the most is that it's really like real life. Like it's true to how you actually write JavaScript. It's not difficult. I think you can do it in 1 hour, maybe over an hour, depends how much you want to play with that. And the idea is that you inherit a code about a stock management system. The task is technically support one more item, one more type of item. But in reality, that's not enough, because the code is, well, let's face it, it's hideous. Like, it's really ugly. It's some nested ifs and elses, and it's completely unreadable. You don't know what to do. So the real thing you really want to do is you want to write unit tests to cover the current code, so you know there will be no regressions whatsoever. And then you want to refactor the code so it's more readable, but it maintains all the qualities the original one had. And as the last step, you add the handling of the product you were asked for. I was given this exercise several years back as an interview exercise. It was a pair programming session, and it remains one of the best interview experiences I've ever had. And recently I remember about this exercise and how fun it was to work on it. And I said, okay, let's try that. And I hit some problems. So first, the solution, I mean, the whole thing is rather old. Like the original Gilded Rose was written in 2011 in C#, and some people transported it to Ruby. I think it was very popular in the Ruby community for a while. And then someone translated it to JavaScript. But back then it was, it's a JavaScript I like today. It's made for browser. You were supposed to test it with Jasmine. That means it kind of dependent on some global variables. That's never nice, right? So I kind of changed the exercise. So what it's now? Now it's an NPM package. And I think that's what I really like, because the interface is just a package. Like, I don't care what happens inside the package, what languages. I mean, if you want to use TypeScript, use whatever you want. Like, the interface is a standard NPM package, which exports one function. My primary goal was to be able to try some functional JavaScript, and I actually did the refactoring in Load.hfp, very great one. But you can use whatever you want. That's what I think is the beauty of the NPM package. And I added some nice more features. One of them is I wrote a test, like I prepared a test for you in Jest, which I think is more standard way. And that's one more thing, it's a surprise. So how to start this exercise, and I really recommend you doing that. Go to the repo, which is on github.com/RobinPokorny/GildedRoseJavaScript. I will post the link below. And clone this repo or download it, whatever you like. Install NPM, because there are some things done for you. I mean, the code itself don't have any dependencies. It doesn't have any dependencies at all. You can add them if you want, but that's just dependency for Jest. Some prepared Jest files. You really can start. You don't have to think about setting up everything. It is there. It doesn't do anything, of course. That's up to you to do. And that's like the second step I would recommend you. The first step, you should not forget. The first step is read the README file. It describes the challenge. It describes what items are already handled, how they are handled, what should happen with them, what should not happen with them. And it also describes the product you are supposed to add. So once you read that, go through the code. You will see it's ugly. And then I would recommend you to write tests in Jest, which kind of validate your thoughts, how you understood what is written in the file. And then I would say think about your strategy. Like, how do you think this kind of thing should be handled? Like, what is the actual interface? What is happening behind the scenes? How you want the logic to be, with the idea that you want to add a new product and eventually maybe even more. So just think about that. And then while running the test you wrote on the background in a watch mode, you can start rewriting, and then either really rewriting by moving or by writing from scratch. That's, for example, what I did. I really started from scratch because I didn't want anything from the original file. And once you are happy about that, and hopefully all your tests are passing, so you kind of maintain the current functionality but with better code, then I would move on and try to add a new product. Again, I would go TDD, so first add the tests for that kind of file which are failing at first, and then try to make them green by writing the code. And then there's a last step which is very new, and that's what I did, and it's like a bonus which is not included in the other source codes or like some other katas, and that is validation. There is this secret file or this secret command which you can use to run validations on the code and make sure you did it right. Why do I say that? Because on the first try, I did not try it. Sorry. Oh. What is this thing? What? Why did I add the validation? Well, that's very easy. Because you don't know if you are really done. You don't know if you passed it, if you didn't forget about anything. And there's the thing. I did. When I tried this several days ago and I refactored in LotusFP, I did forget about some edge cases. And I only discovered that when I was trying to write an exhaustive test for the exercise. And then I tried to run them like on the original code and on my code, and there were errors. When you are done, and I urge you to only do that when you are really done, when you think you finished, when you have refactored the code, when you added a new product, then you can run yarn validate or npm run validate, whatever you prefer, and then it will run this secret test which is included in the repo. It is obfuscated. Technically you can gather the content, but again, that would be against what you want to do. Like, don't try to read the test file, just try to run it, and then if the tests in it pass, you've done perfect job, that's great, everything works, the new product is added as it should be. If not, as I said, do not worry, it's probably you forgot about some edge case, and I'm really talking about edge cases because we're talking about, like, we handle numbers and some number intervals, so you should look at them again, make sure you've covered all of them. Maybe you can even try calculating the coverage of the tests, whatever works for you. Maybe you can just change the code you have, or maybe it would be easier to start from scratch, whatever. I would say it is a difficult exercise, so don't worry if you don't get it on the first try. I did not, as I said, so because it's a learning experience. And then an optional last step, like really last, is I would like to see your code, and I would say other people as well. So please, if you really do this exercise, play with that, use your favorite technology, use your favorite, I don't know, transpiler, whatever you want. As I said, the only interface is the npm package itself. And the function that provides. So other than that, create new files. I don't know, whatever you like, whatever is the new thing, whatever comes up today in the JavaScript world. Just use that, just try that. Try it several times. I mean, I remember I first did it in like a normal JavaScript, then I tried to utilize LotusFP as much as I could. Maybe I will try it next time with Ramdour or some other library which will help me. And then please share it with us, post it in the comments or just publish it on Twitter so we can see your code, and when you finish it, you can look at other people's solutions, maybe see what you made wrong or what worked for other people. And what I like about this exercise, it's rather simple. I mean, the resulting code can be 100 lines or maybe a little more, so it's readable, but still it contains some untrivial business logic, and that's what I think makes it very, very interesting. And hey, let me know how you like this video. Hit the like button if you enjoyed that. If you would like to see more, write me in the comments what you think about this format. I mean, I'm trying this new thing when I'm talking while going to work. And for me, thinking while dog walking really works. So I hope it works for you as well. So let me know in the comments. Subscribe if you would like to know more about JavaScript. And hopefully see you in the next video. Bye. It's really nice here. This is Tier Garden and it's really nice. It's nice. I like to have a morning walk. It's really nice. Let me show you some of that.